All right, welcome back to Hot Copy. We're talking with Tourism Secretary Ramon Jimenez Jr. Questions from Twitter and Facebook. We'll start with this. Batangas Vice Governor Mark Leviste asks, how do you see, this is the, if you want to read it, sir, how do you see Batangas re-emerging as a premier tourist destination? He is the chairman for tourism in Batangas. What are the DOT's plans for Batangas? Well, you know, Batangas has a lot of diving. I used to dive there.
In fact, I think it should be pointed out now. Batangas is a very important touristic spot because it is so near to Manila.
Agree.
You know, Senator Ralph Recto always describes it that way. Mm. Everything's here, and yet it's so near.
Correct. You know? Correct.
And that's true. Batangas has everything that the tourist will want.
Yeah.
So it will reemerge. Fundamentally, because as we fix the gateways, yan ang cluster strategy.
Yeah.
As you fix the airport, as you fix the gateways, the infrastructure will in effect push the tourism out into those areas.
All right, so we have to make it fast. We have a few minutes on air. You have so many questions coming in also. Arnie Trinidad asks, do you have the budget to launch campaigns like what Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, and Korea are doing on international news channels? How do you intend to raise funds for big tourism campaigns?
The best campaigns are not built on money. They're built on a very powerful insight, an offer people cannot refuse.
Yes, but do you have the money for the international
That's what I keep saying. The best media strategy is a great idea.
Okay.
So if you've got a great idea, you only have to air it once to have the impact of 10 of your competitor.
Okay.
That's the now. Those are brave words, but I have no choice. Everybody knows I've got a tight budget. I have no choice. The insight has to be powerful.
Okay. Arnie Trinidad says Asian airlines are making a killing from getting a share of the foreign passenger market, while our airline companies are lagging behind these airlines. Thus, the DOT have the mandate to help increase passengers of local airline companies. How do you intend to do this?
Again, we are committed to two things. Inviting people to visit our country. Necessarily, when you have open skies, you also invite foreign airlines to bring people into your country.
Yeah. Rates, that's ideally, necessarily part of that. Rates become cheaper.
We are, however, committed to making sure that our airlines have the ability to compete. And we are very open to discussions about how they can continue to do that.
Okay. Paul Ramos asks, as Tourism Secretary, what kind of infrastructure do you think our country badly needs?
Okay, we have to improve our gateways, and those are airports and ports.
Ports.
Those are primary.
Ports.
And then the infrastructure or the key touristic roads that lead to the important touristic areas.
Like what? For example, I'm curious, give me one.
Well, for example, the road between, Manila, Batangas, Cavite, all those roads have to be absolutely in tip-top condition.
Yeah, I'm curious, like El Nido, for example. Isn't there a more aggressive way? Because we're so dependent on businessmen.
Okay.
But in El Nido, there are so many islands that you can develop, like the Maldives. I went to the Maldives.
Yes.
Every island has a resort.
Yes.
They live on tourism.
Yes. Well, here's the thing about, let's talk about El Nido. Okay. The infrastructure, of course, on the ground will be improved.
Yeah.
But at the same time, people must be aware, El Nido is an ecotourism.
We
cannot suddenly be so successful that you've got jet skis crisscrossing the islands. It's not that kind of a place.
Okay.
You want that kind of fun, you'll be directed towards Boracay.
But it lacks resorts, El Nido.
Yes.
There's only, if you go to El Nido, there's only one.
That's correct.
Which is that's the Ayala Resort now. They own it. Yeah.
Yes. I'm not that familiar with the actual contracts, but there are new resorts
coming
going to
up.
Come up soon.
Okay. Yes. All right. Rona Gavino asks, if you were the tourism secretary at the time when Mendoza killed the Hong Kong hostages at the Quirino Grandstand, what would you have done to save the country's reputation? Would you have gone to Hong Kong? What would you have done?
Well, Bertie Lim did in fact go to Hong Kong, and he played a crucial role in at least helping to calm down people's nerves. But to make the best of a horrible situation like that, all you can do is reassure Hong Kong that the Philippines has irreversibly learned very important lessons from this.
Yeah, but they seem disappointed.
Well,
okay.
It takes time. This is not just ordinary hurt. This was genuine sadness. No?
Uh-uh.
So we must respect that.
Okay. Dennis Cleofe asks, name your top three personal favorite tourist destinations in the Philippines and describe each of them in one word. Wow, this is like a branding test.
I'm very sorry. As tourism secretary, I have to tell you,
my three
favorite destinations are Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao.
Wow! You're good, huh? You're good. Okay. Now, many people, I mean, here on Twitter are saying, finally, a brilliant mind in government. I mean, I read it somewhere here. But that could also be, is that pressure for you?
What? You must appreciate the fact that all your government officials have to thrive under pressure.
Okay.
That's what it's all about now. But I make no bones about the fact that I will succeed only with the support of the people.
Okay. J.W. Perez, 2001. This is going to be fast. Clearly, this guy is from tourism. We waited since 2008 to have the new law passed. Then only October 2011, the implementing rules have been finished.
That's true. On the new tourism law,
okay.
Republic Act 9593, going to push through with the new IRR or the rules and regulations. That will happen.
What will you do with the Tourism Congress, by the way? There was a fight between them and the other group. How are you going
to
do that?
We are working very hard to make everyone friends again. And the indicators are very good.
Okay, but they were saying that these people aren't stakeholders. I mean, that he owns a real estate.
There have been too many sweeping statements. The fact of the matter is, the overwhelming majority are now prepared to come together.
Okay. Mark Wolfs is asking, you look at the tourism offices abroad, they're so fresh and invigorated. Most staff has been there more than 5 years. He's saying you need fresh and invigorated staff. Well, are you going to hire people?
There's a difference. Does he mean younger staff? Okay. It takes time to do that.
Okay.
Fresh and invigorated. I try to talk to them every day.
Okay.
That's part of the job.
Okay. I'm rushing because, you know, I want people to be happy. I ask their questions. Philippine Cass is asking, how are you going to ensure that Boracay is not overbuilt? Oh. Actually,
there are very serious consultants. Again, it's too early in the game, but you should know that there is, in fact, a group already looking very seriously at that. The primary studies have already been completed.
Stop building.
Well, it's not as simple as that.
Okay.
You have to respect local government prerogatives.
Yeah.
The plan to ensure the long-term viability of Boracay is done.
Yeah. Okay. But, sir, Boracay needs an incinerator, huh? Because the trash at the back, it's there. And then you can't put the trash out to sea. All right. JPW Perez again, is Tiesa ready to take in applications for tourism enterprises already? What is that?
Yes, it is.
Explain.
Tiesa is actually the Tourism Infrastructure and Enterprise Zone Authority. This is the new name of the Philippine Tourism Authority.
Okay. Are you open to hospitable Philippines?
As an idea, why not? Let's discuss it.
Okay. All right. MC Bermuda, one of the problems during Lim's time was he didn't have good PR. How are you working to improve your relationship with the media? I don't think you need any help with that.
By getting up early in the morning and talking to Karen David. That's how we take it.
All right. Okay. San Miyagi, this is a good one. From Naiya, tourists need a convenient way to commute to major stops like shuttle buses or trains and maps too.
Agreed.
Like Hong Kong.
I agree. Again, we have to create the momentum generates the pressure and the income to create all of that.
All right, this is good. RB Bautista, my foreign friends were amazed with the beautiful spots in Manila. But when they saw the trash in Manila Bay, they were disappointed.
Well,
how are you going to do that?
We are not without our problems, right?
Yeah.
That's part of what we have to fix.
You can make trash a tourist attraction. If magawa mo yun, bibilib na ako sa'yo.
But that's part of what we have to fix.
Uh-oh.
I can make typhoons a tourist attraction.
You can.
Yes.
But trash is a tough one.
Yeah.
But so are you coordinating with MMDA? I mean,
Oh, yes.
The ENR, oh, yes. Are you?
Yes, you have to.
Okay, yeah. All right. You have so many questions for Secretary Lim. We're only until 9 o'clock. We have 2 minutes left. Okay, is it really necessary to change the Wow Philippines ad? Quickly.
Is it?
Necessary to change the Wow Philippines ad?
Yes, we need a fresh one.
All right. Your last words, this is what people in Twitter are saying. Watching DOT Secretary Jimenez is so uplifting. Magaling ang Pilipino. So now the pressure is on you.
Well, you said it. Magaling ang Pilipino. Okay? And you, at the very end, will be the one to decide whether people will come to pay you a visit or not.
Mm-mm.
Okay? Do your part, because you are now called upon to be an agent of tourism.
Mm-mm.
And that's my message to everybody.
And I think you said it best in the beginning of the show. Ang problema sa atin, hindi natin kinakarir ang tourism. Simply said, we don't take the money in tourism seriously. Huh? Countries live off tourism. Do you think we can reach that?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Vietnam has more tourists, I think, than us. In fact, there's nothing to see there.
I have yet to find a Filipino who doesn't enjoy hosting visitors.
Yeah,
we enjoy it. Okay. Now we've got to turn it into a career.
Yeah, so. Career. All right, Secretary Jimenez.
Thank you very much.
Good day and good luck.
Thank you.
You have our support. All right, and the replay is 6:30 tonight on ANC if you want to see the interview with Tourism Secretary Ramon Jimenez. That's it. Start today. I'm Karen Davila. Have a good weekend, everyone. See you on Monday. And I don't know. I think, are we having Customs Commissioner Ruthie Biazon on Monday? Well, why not? Let's claim it. So he has to show up on Monday. See you, everyone. Have a good weekend.